Joining me in our Washington studio is Harlan Ullman. He's chairman of the Killowen Group, a firm that advises senior executives and government leaders, and a senior advisor for the Atlantic Council. Harlan, welcome to our program. So much to dissect: allegations of lies, cover-ups, cheating, blatant racism. What stood out to you when you heard Cohen's testimony?
This is truly a sad day for America. You have somebody who's convicted of lying to Congress, who is not necessarily credible, saying things that most Americans are going to believe about our president, and that he did have an affair, and that he has behaved in scandalous ways. Now, whether this has risen to the level of impeachment for treason, bribery, and high crimes and misdemeanors, perhaps Robert Mueller, the special counsel, will reveal. But politically, this has been extremely damaging. Does it mean the president is going to be in huge legal trouble? At this stage, not yet. But politically, this is not good for anybody and not good for America.
So you're saying after all this, this testimony could not make a whole lot of difference for President
Over time. Look, 20 years ago, Bill Clinton was impeached for lying over an affair. At that stage, America was a superpower. China was not in the ascent. The Soviet Union had imploded. Nothing happened. Today, you're going to report about Pakistan and India, what we have happening in North Korea, what's happening in the Middle East. America is in the decline in terms of influence. This does not help our credibility overseas.
And Cohen's testimony, Harlan, wasn't just about the alleged affair or the
Absolutely.
Alleged cheating. Anything explosive in there about the Russia investigation that could link things together?
Not yet. There are no real guns or smoking howitzers, but there's a lot of circumstantial evidence. Nothing that Mr. Cohen said is not known about Mr. Trump in terms of the way he's behaved in business for 40 years. But we'll see what Mr. Mueller says, because when you have all these people around him, Paul Manafort, who's been convicted, personal attorney, people dealing with Russia, there's an awful lot of smoke, and one suspects there's got to be fire.
If we can put up that tweet from President Trump again, that Jim, our reporter, was also talking about. He said he had other clients too. He was just disbarred by the state Supreme Court for lying and fraud. He did bad things unrelated to Trump, referring to himself in third person. He's lying in order to reduce his prison time using Crooked's lawyer, meaning referring to the insults for Hillary Clinton, Crooked Hillary. Surprising?
Absolutely not. And you saw the Republicans, you see the Republicans on the Hill attacking his credibility. The problem is that Mr. Cohen has a smoking gun. It's a check that Donald Trump, as president, gave a check, which probably breaks campaign financing law. This is not a big deal. Other administrations, Obama administration, Clinton's, broke campaign financing. This hurts Mr. Trump, but I don't think this is a mortal blow. We'll see what Mr. Mueller has to reveal.
And some shocking revelations about President Trump's alleged racist behavior. Cohen saying Trump is a racist, who once asked if he could name a country run by a black person that wasn't a blank hole, using an expletive here, and said Trump once told him black people would never vote for him because they were too stupid. And I'm quoting here. I mean,
I don't think that really necessarily proves that one is racist. You say stupid things, people say stupid things. Look, you have a president who's...
The optics are
horrible. And so now you have a president who is accused of being a con man, who's cheated on his wife, who has lied. That does not help America. And whether he's a racist in these circumstances is a lesser offense.
Republicans tried to discredit him. Did it work?
No. I think that Cohen's testimony, what I saw, was quite compelling because people are prepared to believe this. The question really remains, what does Mr. Mueller find out? Because you have all these sources of information that point that there was some kind of conspiracy and possibly obstruction of justice. Not collusion, which is not a crime, but obstruction of justice. And we have to wait for the Mueller report. This may be good television for some because it's extremely entertaining, but to repeat, this is damaging for America.
We'll leave it there. Harlan Ullman, thank you so much.